Hello everyone, my name is Carlos de la Fuente and together with José Javier Valero, Francisco José Castellanos and Jorge Calvo Zaragoza, we worked on a project that is called Multimodal Image and Audio Music Transcription. Okay, the idea of this project is to validate the hypothesis that the multimodal combination of OMR and AMT works and improves unimodal results of both. OMR, optical music recognition, and AMT is automatic music transcription. Okay, the objective of both is obtaining a structured digital representation. In the case of OMR, from a sheet music image, and in the case of AMT, from acoustic recordings. Okay, if we talk about the background, we have based this work in non-musical scenarios. In this case, in text, specifically in text transcription with the recognition, TR, and automatic speech recognition, ISR, exploring the possibility of combining both. The authors talk about it is more comfortable to talk than to write a text. And the same thing happens in the music area, that it's more comfortable to play an instrument than to write all the music tokens. So with this idea and the thing that we know that with previous studies shows that OMR is good at predicting the tokens that can infer it from the sheet music image, like the key, the clef, and the bar line. And on the other hand, AMT is good at predicting the frequencies of notes. Our approach is a fusion at the decision level. We can say that it's a fusion at a sequence level at the end of the train. When we try to fusion the sequences of tokens of both models. In this case, we have to speak about our methodology that we can divide it in two steps. The first one, neural end-to-end based recognition system. We have on the one hand, for OMR, we introduce a sheet music image to our CRNN network, and we use the Lisp function CTC, and at the end we obtain a posteriorum. On the other hand, for AMT, we have to synthesize an audio to obtain a spectrogram, specifically a CQT spectrogram, and we pass this spectrum to our CRNN network, and we get the same a posteriorum. What is a posteriorum? A posteriorum is a matrix where we have all the probabilities of all the tokens per frames. So with these two posteriorums, we introduce our second step, the multimodal fusion policy. This step we can divide it in four steps too. First of all, ready decoding policy. What does mean? What does this mean? That we need a sequence of tokens, not a matrix. So we get the most probable token. And at the same time, we have to save the probability of this token. The second step is we have to merge the consecutive symbols. This is because a token can be more than one frame. So we have to average all the probabilities to have only one probability per frame. So we make this average. At the same time, we remove the blank symbols estimated by the CTC. And at the end, we have two sequences. In this case, we have to align both, and we use a local alignment algorithm. In this case, Smith-Waldman. And we have three options. The first one, both sequences agree on a token, so we include it. Both sequences disagree on a token, so we get the token with the highest probability. Or if a sequence misses a symbol, so we get the symbol of the other sequence. About our experimentations, for the evaluation of our approach, we consider the Camera Premium database. We have 87,000 samples, and at the end we only use 22,000 samples, 60% for training, 20% for validating. and 20% for staging. And the metric that we used, it was a Cymor error rate. So here we have an example. In this example, if we see this example, we can validate our hypothesis that in the case of OMR, we can see that it's good at predicting the key and the clef. And on the other hand, EMT is good at predicting the pitch of the notes. So at the end, when we fusion both, we get a better results. About our result, we have to say that in preliminary experimentation, when training both the OMR and AMT system with the same amount of data, we get better results with OMR. So in this case, we propose four controlled scenarios. The first one is a scenario if we have the same share in OMR and AMT. We can see that we have a relative error decrease of approximately 30% of share. So it's useful, the fusion. Other one, a scenario B, if is it the case, if one of them works better than the other. In this case, we have a relative improvement of almost 19%. In scenario C, is the same case that in the scenario A, but in this case with a small margin to improve. We get a relative improvement of almost 40%. The last one, in this one, we train both model with the same data. We can see that OMR gets a result of 2.38% of sales. So we don't have a margin to improve. In this case, the fusion is not necessary and at the same time is not useful. So here we have a table with all the scenarios and the results of both the results of fusion and at the same time with the relative improvement, with the relative error improvement. And the conclusion that we can obtain, it is the results obtained, it validate our initial hypothesis that the multimodal combination of OMR and AMT improve transcription results. Our results attain up to around 40% of relative error improvement. And like a future work, in light of the results, different research avenues may be now explored. And we plan to explore this idea to polyphonic music. That is all, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Carlos. Maybe we can continue with questions that could lead to the main discussion, panel session.
Ichiro, raise his hand. Yes.
Can I go? The chair doesn't give me. Jorge, are you a chair too? Anyways, thank you, Carlos. Somehow I missed it. How are the audio generated?
Which one? In AMT, in the case of AMT. Yes,
well,
in...
that's the only way you can generate audio, I guess.
Yes, that's true. In this case, in the database Camera Primos, we have a MIDI file. So we synthesize the audio to get an audio signal. And then we transform this audio to a spectrum. A CQT spectrum.
So MIDI, you just use any instrument? Like
we use a piano instrument.
Piano instrument? Okay. Thank
yes.
you. Any other questions? Well, I have a topic that we could discuss, if anyone else wants to suggest something, which has something to do with what Carlos was presenting. And I just wanted to open a discussion in metric systems used in OMR, the measurements used in OMR. He mentioned the symbol error rate, and I wanted to talk more about different stages and how do we evaluate them and finding maybe a more standardized evaluation metric. And maybe here we could call the other presenters from the other papers in this session.
In my case, I use SERP because previous studies use it and validate that it was a good one. So in this case, my work is only a work to validate one hypothesis, so I use it one. I didn't compare it.
Yeah.